everybody, it's your girl Bunny. So we are to episode 9 of the Netflix original series, Jim Henson's The Dark Crystal: Age of Resistance. Season 1, episode 9, The Crystal Calls. That's all coming up next. It's Bunny. Comes to after bringing and getting a lot of the wisdom and foresight gift from the Century Tree, and also unfortunately taking the darkness. She awakens and she sees over her Madra Argo or Argot over her. She is the healer and the helper of the Grot Gelfling, and we see Rion and a bunch of her other family members standing over her. And Deed can't remember how she got to where she was and how she's away from the Century Tree, and they're telling her, because of you, the rest of the Gelfling were able to escape. Because remember, they no longer have the mind-changing or the mind-bending creatures that were in their ears to go to their brains and telling them what to do from the Ascendants. So they're able to tell her, because of you, the people have been released. They're no longer under mind control. And that's more of the Gelfling that are free. Because now we have the Ascendants, which are the spider creatures that have agreed to be allies of the Gelfling in order to move forward. Deet says, that's wonderful, that's great, but at the same time, I've got to get going. Rion and I have got to get going. We have got to find the double-edged sword, and I think I know where it is. And then Argo, because I'm guessing that's how you pronounce it. And she says, oh, well, one second. And she gets her cane and she starts to beat it against the ground. And then all of a sudden we see the dual-edged sword in her cane. And I'm like, really? And they asked her, why didn't you tell us that you had it? Now she has one side of the dual sword, but they need to find the other half. And she said, well, you never asked me. And I didn't know you were looking for it until now. And I'm thinking as the viewer, okay, Madra. Meanwhile, the Sketsis, they are trying to pull more and more essence from Gelfling in order to restore the Hunter, because they feel that if they get enough, they can restore him. And if they're unsuccessful, they want to be able to put his body up and show it as a display, because he was one of the strongest and they don't want to show any weakness. They still believe that they are eternal and they can't die. So when they are trying to get all of this essence from Brea and Madra Farah, we have Olga that comes in, and the Sketsis say, we thought we banished you from here. And she says, I heard about the Hunter and I just came to show my respects, but it looks like he's on the verge of death. And we have the Emperor that says, we never die, we are eternal. And Olga says, you can't get all of the essence that you need from just a few Gelfling. You'll need something that's more powerful. And they asked her what she suggests, and she says, well, me. The Sketsis are so greedy with power, they agree to the terms that, hey, we can let these Gelfling go. If Olga says that she's more powerful and we can get more essence from her, then we're good to go. So they let everybody go. They let Brea go. They let Celadon go. And as they are leaving, we see that the machine is pulling the essence from Olga, and then the Hunter is regaining consciousness and coming back alive, and it pulls and pulls the energy, and all of a sudden we see the Hunter. He is able to retrieve some of that essence, and he comes back alive. While he's come back alive, of course, we have the other Gelfling trying to escape, and they come in contact with, of course, the battle general. And he's basically telling them, you're little, where are you gonna go? You don't plan on fighting, do you? Let's just make this easy. And of course, we have Princess Tavra, she tries to defend her sisters to the best of her ability. And Celadon and Brea, they're telling her, you know, we got to try to at least escape. And she's like, no. And in the midst of them trying to have a little scuffle, we have the battle general. He stabs and kills Princess Tavra, one of the sisters. And they, of course, you know, they're sad. They're having a brief mourning there. But in the midst of her fighting, she is able to give some good blows as well. And as that happens, we have Brea and Celadon to go forward and still trying to escape. So we show that in the room where we have the scientists, they are still pulling the essence and all of the energy and all of the life out of Olga, and they push it and they push and they push it to the limit. And then we see Olga disappears. But when Olga disappears, we see the hunter die. So there was so much there, but it wasn't enough to keep him in that form, and Olga has disappeared. The other Gefling, they escape, and as they reach stone in the wood, they take a break and they camp to rest. Madra Argo, she says that the other half of the double-edged sword is in stone in the wood. So she calls on, I think it's called a land strider, to take Rion to a specific place in stone in the wood so he can look for the other half of the sword, which in its totality will be the dual sword. Chamberlain is able to convince the emperor and everybody else that they shouldn't fear. The Gelfling have, they're away now. They've gotten away. That was a bad exchange. But what we can do, since we have this essence from all of the other deceased Gelfling, that we can build another army out of carcasses that we have. And so the emperor is impressed and gives Chamberlain back his seat next to his side. And with that, Chamberlain also suggests that they should set up Hunter as a statuesque form, as symbolism that they are strong, that they are eternal, and that they shouldn't just give up on Hunter even though Hunter's gone. But they want to have the symbolism that they are strong. They don't want to discourage any of the Skeksis that may come their way to say, oh wow, the Hunter has died. So they put him up statuesque, kind of prop his body up, so the other Skeksis can see, yes, we are eternal, and maybe he's just knocked out and he's not dead. Rion reaches a part of stone in the wood where he has a good idea of where the sword may be, and he is right. He sees that there is this pit fire in which people could warm up and warm up their swords and get heat and reshape their blades, and he's able to see it stabbed into this everlasting fire that keeps going and keeps going. And he sees within it, after he pulls out the sword, that there is this blue flame or blue kind of essence of light that is in that fire. He learns that this blue flame represents the unity of all of the seven clans of Gelfling. And at the same time that he is seeing this blue flame emerge, the Skeksis are also seeing an image start to form within the crystal. From there, he realizes that he is able to share a message via the flame that all of the Gelfling can hear and can see. So he's making an announcement to all of the seven clans of Gelfling that we must come together, that we must fight as one, that we must rebel, and we must have a resistance together against the Skeksis. And the Skeksis are seeing this as well. They are seeing that the crystal is different and is starting to convey this message. And they are nervous and they are looking around and like, even if they get all of the Gelfling together, it's still not enough to defeat us. We are Skeksis. They can get everyone in the world to help them. It's still not enough. We are still the dominant, strong beings here. And let them get together. Let them decide on how they will fight us. But we have the strength. We have the numbers. And they try not to let that get to them. And they amp each other out up. And they start to hold up armor. And they start to chant. And they start to get together. Meanwhile, the Gelfling on the other parts of Thra hear this message and see this message. And of course, now they can't help but to know the truth. They can't help to not think that Rion must have killed her, and Rion murdered somebody, and he's not an honorable soldier. So everyone is able to see the truth. And this is the unity that they have been trying to set out since episode one. They finally have it. Everybody's got the message. Now it's time for all of the Gelfling to get together in order to plan a defeat of the Skeksis. That was the end of the episode. Only one more episode left. I hope you have enjoyed these very brief recaps that I've been giving you. Subscribe, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any posts, and follow me on Instagram. Same profile name, official_bun_e, and I will see you for episode 10. Bye.